Hey everybody, Tom Barnes here, Chicago Scene at the Big Mini Puck Club here in the Wicker Park neighborhood. They've been open for over a month, and this is everything that your childhood was when you went mini golfing, mixed with what do you wanted as an adult, meaning you can drink and play mini golf all in one setting. There's 9 holes here. They're custom built by the 2 owners, Nick and Austin. I'm gonna go talk to them now for the Chicago Scene. Let's get our golf on, yeah? All right, I've made my way inside with Nick and Austin. And as you can tell from the artwork and the putt-putt happening behind you, you guys have made yourself feel right at home in the Wicker Park neighborhood. How are you guys?
Doing well. How are you, Tom?
I'm great. Thank you for letting me come in and crash the little party you got going on behind you as far as business is going on. But a mini putt inside of a bar in the city, I don't think it's something that I've seen before. I've seen everybody knows mini putt from when we were kids back in the day. Is that kind of where you got the idea from, except now you're adults and you want to have a beard along with golfing?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's a novel concept, but I think the crux of the story is that people want to do things when they're drinking. They don't just want to sit around and watch TV anymore. They want to feel like they're accomplishing something. And they want to like challenge their friends and have fun while they're drinking a beer or a great cocktail.
Yeah, so tell me about the cocktails that you have here. I mean, is it craft beer? Is it stuff from the neighborhood? What do you guys have on tap here?
Yeah, I mean, I think being in Chicago, we're a little spoiled with how much great craft beer is around. So we definitely lean into local. We have like 10 cocktails, house cocktails that we crafted. A lot of golf puns in there. Too many maybe for some people.
Give me an example.
So yeah, like the Back Nine Bananarama. That's actually a banana bourbon drink that catches people off guard, but people love it.
Uh-huh.
And then we have, a little bit of wine, some seltzers. So general bar program, we try to keep it fun and light. And definitely the space, like it blends together with the bar and the mini golf. We have a little halfway house on the bar, on the course, so you can grab a drink or refill while you're golfing right after the turn.
Just beyond your shoulders over there, right?
Exactly.
And then I noticed just the artwork alone, the neon artwork, which is a little play on words from an old 90s song, which I gotta say, well done. So it's a warm space, and it's made for what you guys were saying, kind of people that you guys relate to, right?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, as much as it is a place where you can grab a drink and kind of hang out with your friends, like, it's a great date spot. It's during the day, we are family friendly. Before 5 p.m., minors are allowed, so you can bring your kids here and have fun with your children. And I think depending on the time of day and when you're here, the vibe sort of changes. And I think that's the space that we wanted to create.
So when the vibe does change, does it the music change? Does it get louder? How does that work? Just for people who might, who have kids or maybe are coming in at that time period of when the time might be changing as far as family to a little bit more bar scene.
Yeah, I mean, the music definitely gets louder and maybe the parental advisory sticker comes off the CDs that we're running a little bit. But, like the 90s song that we paid homage to, like, we like to have throwback nights as well. So I think there's an older crowd that is over 21 that might appreciate some of the nostalgia that we've brought into the space.
Yeah, I mean, nostalgia everywhere in a very modern way, and that's great. And you can see that by the I don't even know the holes, the little mini putt holes that you have here. You guys did this on your own. This is like from your brains. I'm sure you did enough mini golfing back in the day, or you might have taken inspiration from one place or another, but you certainly not from around here, because you guys are not from around here. You're East Coasters. You met in college, and your fathers were carpenters, and that's kind of how all this kind of started happening behind you guys, right?
Yeah, I mean, we've been kicking around business ideas for about 10 years now, and our fathers are carpenters. It doesn't mean I grew up like, an apprentice to my dad building houses or anything, but I certainly knew.
Here, son, here's a birdhouse.
Yeah, but we've used tools before. We understand some of the general concepts. Certainly, yeah, we've all played mini golf. I think a lot of people have thought, it'd be cool to design a course one day. And so we really tried to lean into kind of the old school, it's like a summer camp vibe. There's not a lot of technical things with the whole, kitschy lights and electronics, which a lot of people ask for those things, but we really tried to lean into a lot of wood.
Yeah, we don't need that. We have that enough in our day, right?
Yeah. A lot of kind of harkening back to the old school days, a lot of brick in the space. So we just tried to design the holes to be fun but challenging, using vertical space given that we don't have a huge footprint in here. And I think we seem to have accomplished that based on early feedback. People have gotten us a lot of compliments on the course, so I think it's definitely the thing that I'm the most proud of.
Yeah, you guys built this in the basement, right? Of this very building? Like, were you freaking out a little bit as you're building it, knowing they had to fill the space?
Yeah, I mean, so there was a lot of measuring involved, you know, measure twice, cut once sort of thing. So yeah, we did a lot of the framing in the basement. And then,
I'm going to have to redo that again.
Yeah, certainly. I mean, you know, and like Austin was saying, we use vertical space a lot. And then some of the pieces we just specifically designed to different elements of the room. Like there's the corner hole over there. There's the half pipe in the back. And those sort of just like fit perfectly because we, you know, took our, you know, pen and paper up here and sort of drew out the dimensions based on what we had to work with. And then went down to the basement, framed them up, brought them all up here, laid the greens down, and then did the finish work. And it was, you know, all in, each hole probably took us off and on probably a week. So you've got like 9-ish weeks of whole building designing behind you at the moment.
Literally blood, sweat, and tears put into this thing for sure. And what, as we're sitting here talking, I'm going to date myself a little bit, but it reminds me of a portion of a movie called Overboard back in the day with Kurt Russell and Goldie Hawn, where they built a mini putt golf course. Similar, but not completely, because this is you guys. This is a whole different story. But nonetheless, still building the dream of a mini putt course of your very own, right?
Yeah. Well, yeah, for sure. And then that was Austin. My love story is similar to Goldie and Kurt Russell's, right? Yes. We just didn't get married at the end of it.
Right. No, I saw that on your blog. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I think as we were building the space out, we would constantly think like, you know, what would I want to see in a bar and mini golf course if I walked into one as a patron? So, you know, that's what we tried to build.
And for people who want to come by, what's the best way to do this? I imagine you guys get busy, and with the social protocols and everything going on, what would you recommend people to do?
We strongly encourage reservations. Those can be made on our website at bigminiputtclub.com/minigolf. But we also do our best to accommodate walk-ins, depending on the day of the week. Obviously, you can fluctuate for wait times. But if you do want to try to walk in, come here and talk to our host. And if, you know, if there's space, we'll do our best to fit you in. But at the moment, reservations are the best way to get yourself guaranteed.
Just like if we were going to end a round of mini golf here, at the end there, you have a way where the ball return, and a lot of people might be familiar with that. What do you call that? Is that just the last hole, or is that to have a specific name that I just don't know?
Yeah, it's definitely called a few different things. It's a bonus hole, the unofficial 10th hole, ball return. So you can win prizes over there. Most people look at it and say, oh, this is impossible, and then more people than we maybe want are winning every single day.
So what kind of prizes can people get?
We're giving out free merch, free drinks, and free mini golf.
Awesome. And before we get out of here, the artwork in here, specifically this one here on the wall, you want to give a shout out? Is it a local artist? Is Chicago in the family here? What's going on?
It's actually a local group called the Big Art Collective here in Chicago. They were in Wicker Park. It's Luis Galindres, Tom Malloy, and Chris Arnold. And they actually are all affiliated with Columbia University, Columbia College.
Awesome. Well, I appreciate it, guys. Thank you very much, and look forward to some mini golf. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.